Just take a drive to the mall.
Take it. You there?
Yeah, Ricky, what's up?
I just wanted to say I'm sorry about what happened to Boozer.
Yeah, probably not as sorry as he is.
Look, Addy wanted you to know that if you hadn't brought her that list of knife, Boozer would be in a hell of a lot more pain right now.
Yeah, well, it just made it easier for you to carve him up.
Anyway, we hope he makes it. He's my friend too, you know?
Hey, listen, thanks for bringing us in, Ricky. I gotta go. Deacon out. Bounties.
Did I just drop kicked a free kill with my fucking bike? That moving seat you see in virtually every action movie? Yep, that was it.
Hey, me again. So, I took Boozer into the Lost Lake camp, and I know. I know, I told you I was never going back there with Iron Mike threatening to break my neck and all, but didn't have a choice. See, Boozer was gonna die, and, well, he still didn't want to go. Hell, I didn't want to go, but, like I said, didn't have a choice. Neither of us did, so it didn't matter. He lost the arm anyway, and now he's stuck. I mean, we're stuck. Goddamn schizo. You know, I can't remember if I told you about this clown, but he's the kind of asshole that's glad all this shit went down. He says he was gangbanging in Sacramento and Fresno. I don't remember, but he says he's not from around here, and he's not. Claims he was dealing drugs and guns from California, Oregon, and then everything went to hell. And you know what? I think he's full of shit. To me, he kind of looks like a frat boy, like he was on the lacrosse team peddling sodas at a mini mart. No, man. He would have had a cushy job at his old man's accounting firm making copies and getting everyone their morning coffee, you know, making more in a day than I've ever made in a week. You know, it's this game that Boozer and I used to play before we rode out of Lost Lake for good. We used to call it, Who You Were. You know, we'd look at someone, we'd try to guess who they were before the ship went down, you know. You know, I met a few drug addicts, a lot of ex-cons, no accountants. So, that makes sense. Think about it. The first couple of weeks after the ship went down, Jesus, that was a freak show. There's no way some accountant or pencil pusher lived through that shit, so I don't know, maybe it's because I was telling the truth. I'm not sorry that you missed it. I'm not. Anyway, Boozer and I wanted to head north and get away from all this shit, but that ain't happening anytime soon, or happening ever. Hey. Look on the bright side. Looks like you're stuck with me. Okay. I'll stop by later. See you.
I've been wondering what's been going on. I've been here before, but I don't remember when. And every time we get to where we're entering, I feel my beliefs and hopes surrendering. But I know I'll be coming home soon. Yes, I know I'll be coming home soon.
Lost Lake to Deacon St. John. Are you there?
Yeah, Ricky, what's up?
Iron Mike says you volunteered to stick around, do some runs for the camp, but that you refused to work for Schizo.
Yeah, something like that.
Well, I can't say I blame you. Okay, well, I guess I'm stuck with you. So stop by the mechanic shop, got a job for you.
Yeah, okay. Beacon out. Look me up if you need anything else.
Actually, I think from you, I'm kind of good.
Keep an eye out for more shit.
Addy, you there? Deke and St. John to Lost Lake Infirmary. Come back.
Deke!
Hey.
Feeling a little out of it, you know? You okay? What's going on?
Boozer. Hey. Nothing. I got tired of listening to the Radio Free Oregon. You know, they take so much of this truth or bullshit, you know?
Deke, Addy told me how I'd be dead if it weren't for you. Getting the NI, whatever the fuck, so...
Boozer,
it must have been fun. Hold me down while she fucking wiped away at me. Remember how, Jack carved up that turkey last time we was all together? It kept slipping all over the goddamn table.
Yeah, please, man.
I still feel it. Knife. Worse than the Rippers. If you hadn't been there to pull me down, I don't know what would have happened, Deke. I don't know.
Well, it's done, Boozer. It's done. It's over.
Sorry, I'm feeling a little woozy.
Hey, Addie's gonna kill me if she finds out you're out of bed fucking around.
Yeah, you're a monk. Calling my name. Lost Lake signing off.
Hey, listen, Boozer. Shit.
Where the hell's my ratchet wrench?
Hey, Ricky, you said you had a job for me?
Hey, Deke. Yeah. You remember Shane Riley? Everyone called him Red?
Red Riley. Yeah, never heard of him, but let me guess. Ginger?
What, red hair? No. It was his boots. He wore these rattlesnake boots dyed with god-awful red color. He made quite the impression.
No, I bet.
Anyway, he used to do runs for us back in the day until one day he decides he didn't like the camp credits we were paying. So he up and kills Lindsay Fuller.
Who?
Lindsay. Worked supply before Blair.
Wait a second, so he killed an unarmed woman.
Oh, she was armed. She just wasn't expecting him to shoot her in the face. Will you listen?
I know.
So Red murders her, cleans out her supply hut, and then takes off before anyone knows what's happened. Got away clean.
Oh, that son of a bitch.
Until now. He and his men have been spotted up at Camp Pioneer.
You don't gotta ask. I got this thing about him.
About killing unarmed women. I know. So I knew you'd want to handle it.
Yeah, like I said, I got this covered. What else can you tell me about him?
Not much. Oh, wait. He chews tobacco. I heard he was such an addict that he rounds up cigarette butts, takes out the tobacco, and chews that.
Well, that's disgusting. So now I got two reasons to kill him.
Yeah, but be careful, Deke.
Goddamn war zone. Well, with a title like that, I feel like I'm gonna need to kick up, gear up.
Hey,
this.
Good to see you.
Hey, Ricky, I'm at Camp Pioneer, and it is a goddamn war zone.
What's going on? Are any of our guys there?
No, I don't think so. Sounds like they're clearing freaks. Don't worry. Find this guy. Deacon out. All right, Red, where the hell are you? Newts. Oh, wow, they're killing newts. Okay, what's this? Okay, yes, cigarette butts, yes. This'll help. Prints.
Freaks!
These look like the kind of prints that some fancy cowboy wants.
that's Tobacco's bed. Right fire the door, one gross motherfucker.
Break! Wooden box.
Oh, good. Urine. Jesus. Well, if you gotta go, you gotta go.
Open.
Then his tracks led there, so...
Hiding in one of these shacks, huh?
He had it coming. One that I shot? Fouled it off for me. See, really. Shit, no. Jesus, Ripper!
Come on out.
Is this all about that bitch got herself?
Hi. Overshot my bar, overshot the bridge. Watch my six. I'm a big fan of the back entrance.
Hey, Ricky, I got him.
Deacon, what a relief. Lindsay has some folks she was close to. I'll let him know.
Yeah, okay. I'll see you around, Ricky.
Alright. Go back during the day. Well, I don't think it'll make much difference if it's a nighttime date gig.
It's like Boozer says, I hear a bunk calling my name. I'm ready to go back at it.
Deacon St. John, this is Lost Lake. Come in.
Yeah, Mike, this is Deke.
Heard you brought in Shane Riley, but when I went to the shack to question him, he wasn't there.
About that, Mike. I tried to bring him in. I really did, but he put up a hell of a fight. So he didn't leave me much choice, Mike. He didn't.
You remember what I said about how we do things around here?
Yeah, Mike, I remember.
Lost Lake out.
Thanks, Ricky. Hey, how many drifters you guys got?
I can tell by looking at you. Someone needs help.
Over here!
I got this. Hang on. Hey, it's not safe out here in the shit. I know where there's a camp that...
Camp? Where? Show me. I'll go.
Head to Lost Lake. Ask for Ricky Patel. She'll take you in.
Oh, I was done for. Holy shit, you know? Thank you so much. Oh, man.
Tell them it was Deacon. They'll know. Now just keep running. Stay off the road.
Yeah, it's literally just right there. I mean, I can see it from here. It's right fucking there.
Brian, I'm at one of your beacons.
Which one?
What do you mean, which one? This Nero radio has a GPS, doesn't it?
Yes, of course it does. Okay. You're at Olali Falls. Okay, good. Keep an eye out. A field op is going to be there any minute. O'Brien out.
O'Brien? Oh, God damn it. O'Brien, come in. Your friends are here. O'Brien.
I told you, they're not my friends. Okay, head in on foot.
Yeah, I know. What do you want me to do? Use one of these tracking devices.
Let's lock it down. No, don't, not this time. I'm already tracking this one. Follow the researcher. And she's there to investigate an infected subject. The freak that was tagged in a nearby cave.
A cave? You want me to follow armed Nero goons into a cave?
Just stay close to her. While you're in range, I can intercept her data.
Brian.
I'm still working on the info you want. Don't ask.
Then why the hell am I talking to you?
O'Brien out.
Squad, check in.
I'm good. All good here.
Looks good to me. How's the site look? Clear?
Site check's complete.
The fuck was that?
This is something far worse.
What do you mean?
This virus is on a mission. The freaks are what they are because the virus wants them that way.
What are you saying?
I'm saying... Jesus, what am I saying?
Terrorism? You're saying this was deliberate?
I don't know.
Is that it? Is she done? Yeah. Okay, time to get the hell out of Dodge.
A way out of this cave. Good.
What's she talking about, O'Brien? About this virus, whatever the hell it is, or what it's doing? I want to know what the hell's going on, O'Brien. Why are they out here? What the fuck are you doing? O'Brien?
Okay. I'll be in touch. O'Brien out.
Oh boy, this is gonna get old fast.
With a soldier's eyes, I've seen inside the devil's dreams where young men die. And graveyards open up their arms for mothers left to cry. I have seen the bleeding, and I hate what we've done. But just like every other fool here, I'll keep marching on.